Merry Christmas to everybody. This week has been really busy with the holidays, with work, with preparing and planning. Everything that's going on just been really hectic. So this week we're going to do something also a little bit different. For those of you that live here in the Southern California area, we have the Reptile Super Show coming up on January 10th and 11th at the LA County Fairgrounds in Pomona, California. As always, we do all the local shows, we do the local circuit, we will be there. We always bring some really weird animals. We kind of stand out from a lot of people because of the animals that we like and the things that we bring for people to see. So this week I'm going to give you guys a preview of what we're going to have on the table. Just by luck, everything kind of came into place, got some new shipments, hatched a few new babies, and it's going to be a really good showing. We're going to have a really good presence at that show. So let me show you first, for those of you that like green tree pythons, I've got a nice group of about, I think it's about 13 or 14, Bioc locality. They're farm bred, but they've been with me for anywhere between 8 to 12 months. They're super established. They're really beautiful. The bigger guys that are this size range, these are going to be sexed, and I do have pairs available. So that's this size. They're already going into their color change. And then I have a big assortment of the little guys. These are going to be too small for us to properly sex, but they are going to be available for sale. And I do not bring any of these guys to the show unless they meet my stamp of approval. They have to be performing well, eating, defecating, shedding. So these guys are solid. They're good to go. All right, let's move on. I got a whole bunch of other stuff to show you guys. So at the show, we're also going to have Solomon Island ground boas. I have a good amount of animals that are in this size range. For those of you that follow the Solomon Islands and my importing, the country's been closed, had been closed for several years, and it reopened in January, and then it closed again in April. I was lucky enough to pull in a couple of shipments, not huge ones, but I got some decent amount of animals. These guys are from that shipment. They've been with me for a long time. They were feeding on rodents straight away, and they're feeding weekly. They're aggressive feeders. They're not aggressive animals, but they're really good, strong feeders. I have males and females available, provide pairs, no problem. So we're going to have a pretty wide assortment of these guys, and I also have some bigger ones too that are feeding and doing really well. But I really like these young juveniles. They're super strong feeders, and they do really, really well. We're also going to have some paradisi at the expo, some paradise flying snakes. I was lucky enough to get just a very small amount in the last shipment, so far they're doing really good. So as long as they continue thriving for me and doing well, we'll have those animals that are performing well at the expo. And there is a chance that I may have a couple more coming too, maybe in the next couple of weeks. So I should have pairs available. So that's definitely one of the oddities that you probably won't see at too many expos. I know a lot of people have never seen these with their own eyes, so if you live in the Southern California area, come out to the show and check them out. I'll have them on display. They're a really cool snake. Very, very beautiful. It's going to be definitely worth a look. And for those of you guys that watched last week with the Pitias mucosus video and the babies that I hatched here, now they've shed. So I have a good 3 weeks between now and the show. So I expect these guys, I'm going to start feeding trials today. They have a very fast metabolism. So for those of that pick up and start feeding, I can put several meals through them between now and the expo. So whatever's feeding and doing well, I'll have them at the show. They did shed, and they've got a beautiful, beautiful greenish kind of yellow color to them. I've seen babies before, and they definitely did not look like this. So these are actually really beautiful. And again, they were sired by that sulfur or hypomelanistic looking male to a normal female. So hopefully they've got some good genetics behind them. These were also hatched here from a gravid import. These are Boiga dendrophila from Indonesia. They did really well straight out of the gate feeding on live pinkies. They're still going that direction. And so they're all established, ready to go. So we'll have a very limited number of these available at the expo as well. These Amazon tree boas, these were also born here from a really beautiful yellow and kind of light orange male bred to a female that looks similar to this. So I have three or four of those guys. They're feeding on brain pinkies, and some of them have already just gone over to just taking regular pinkies. But they're also very beautiful. They're all colored, and we'll have those at the expo as well. Another thing that you don't see every day are baby Homolopsis buccata, the Puffase water snakes. I've got five very, very young farm-bred babies. And this is not cantaloupe. Everybody that looks at this stuff asks me why I keep them on honeydew melon and cantaloupe. This is just sponge. But these little guys are so, so cool. Really pretty. They're feeding on guppies. And I've had really, really good luck keeping all the aquatic snakes in treated water with aquarium salt for saltwater tanks, marine aquariums. It's been perfect. It has completely eliminated any sort of fungal issues that are normally associated with the aquatic stuff. Another species of snake that I'm somewhat known for are scrub pythons. So, you know, what would a proper expo be without some scrub pythons there? I've got just a couple of these. These are Maroque or Southerns. They just came in as well, but it's really cool when you get the small ones like this. So they're doing well. And, you know, just like all this stuff, as long as it's doing well, you know, between now and the expo, it'll go. And if it's showing any sort of signs like hesitation to feed or anything like that, I won't take it. But the way these guys are going now, they're going to be there. So scrub pythons, DM Exotics, you know I got to have them. Whoa! And for you guys that are into blue tongue skinks, if you're lucky and I decide that I'm going to part with these, I will bring these two to the show. I'm not sure. We're growing kind of attached to them. These two are just so beautiful and so different. Doing really good, though. So if we do bring them to the show, whoever's lucky enough to pick these up, they're going to get some really, really, really nice, nice blue tongue skinks. And I also have one U.S. captive bred female green anaconda. This was produced by Carl Hermann. And, you know, I was originally keeping this one as a pet, but I might make this one available as well. So it's a very nice animal. We should also have some of these Boiga nigriceps at the expo. And I also am expecting one pair of captive bred Boiga cyanea babies. So if you're into the Boiga and you're attending the show, come check it out. Chances are I got some very tempting animals for you. I also have some Jansenii. I have four of them. So if they're doing well also, they just came, they're kind of new arrivals. So if they're doing well for the expo, I'll have these guys there too. Another Asian colubrid that's not seen so often. This one's in shed. It's the smallest of the four that I have. The others are about double this size. So we'll see. May have them at the expo. It's cool stuff though. I love this stuff. And for anybody attending the Reptile Super Show, you gotta swing by my table. If you wanna see some stuff that is not, you know, readily available, some of the stuff you've never seen before, at least just swing by and take a look, because chances are you'll see some stuff that you've never seen before.